Morning students, welcome to your mathematics class. So in the last class we finished our how to find the LCM by using the three methods and also how to find the HCF by using the three methods we have seen. Okay, and in today's class we learn the relationship between LCM and HCF. What is the relationship between LCM and HCF by considering two numbers? Okay, suppose consider two numbers 18 and 27. So let one number be x, let one number be x is equal to 18, let the second number y is equal to 27. So these are the two numbers I have considered, and now what I am doing is I will try to find my LCM and also their HCF by using any one of the method your wish. As we have the three methods, by using any one of the method try to find the LCM and HCF. Okay, now here I will find out the LCM of 18 and 27. So I am using my division method. Okay. So if I take 2 means in 2 table 18 will go, 2 9s are, but 27 is not divisible. So better we go with 3. As I said, 2 numbers must be divisible. So if I take 3 means 3 6s are 18, 3 9s are 27. Again you take 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. So what is the LCM? So LCM is equal to 3 into 2 into 3. Multiply 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 3s are 55. So this is your LCM. Now find out the HCF. Okay. Now HCF of 18 and 27. Now I will go with my continuous division method. So 18, 27. 18 ones are 80. 2 subtraction 17. 17 minus 8 9. Again you have to choose this divisor 18. So 9 2s are 18, which gives you 0. So what is my HCF? HCF is 9. Okay. So HCF is equal to 9. So I got LCM as 54 and HCF as 9. What I am doing, I am trying to find the relationship. Okay. Now, if you multiply LCM into HCF, now multiply LCM into HCF. Now multiply the LCM which we got 54, multiply into HCF, how much you got? 9. How much it is? 9 4s are 36. So 6, 3. 9 5s are 45. 45 plus 3, 48. So 486 is your product of LCM and HCF. This is your LCM into HCF. Okay. One more. Now you multiply the given numbers x and y. These are the numbers I have taken. Now you multiply these two. Okay. Product. Multiply means product of two numbers. Product of two numbers. So what are the product of two numbers? These are the two numbers. Now you multiply 18 into 27. How much you get? Here you multiply 18 into 27. 7 8s are 56. 7 1s are 7. 7 plus 5 12. Now 2 8s are 16. 2 1s are 2. 2 plus 1 3. Now 6 6 plus 2 8 480. So product of two numbers. So product of two numbers gives you 486. 486. Yes? Now you observe these two. When you are multiplying the LCM and HCF, we are getting 486. And when we are multiplying the given two numbers also, you are getting the same. same answer. Well, that means LCM, by this, you can say that LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. Product of two numbers. So this is your relationship. This is your relationship.
Once again, I will explain you. I have taken two numbers. What happened here? I consider one number as x, the other number as y. Okay. Now, what have done? I have found the LCM. LCM of 18 and 27. How much I got? 54. And HCF also I found. How much I got? 9 over. Now, I have multiplied LCM and HCF, which gives you 486. And here, product of the two numbers, means these are the two numbers. No? So, I am multiplying these two. So, how much I got? 486. So when you are getting the same answer means these two are equal. When 486 is equal to 486, I can equate these two. That means LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So this is your relationship. Clear, Shina? So try note it down in your notebook and we'll discuss one more problem also. Okay?
Product of what? Product of two numbers. What are those?
got 3. Okay. HCF is, LCM is 120, HCF is 3. And product, here you found the product. How much? 360. Now multiply 3 into 0, 0. 3 into 0, 6. 3 into 1, 7. 3 is equal to 360. Is it clear? Yes. You got the same answer. 360 is equal to 360. Yes, sir. So this is how you have to find. When your two numbers are being given means, this is the way of doing and checking the relationship. Okay. So here I will give you numbers. You try to find the relationship. Okay. This is your homework I am giving you. So first one is 8,25. Second one is 12,48. So for these two numbers, you have to do this entire process and you have to check this relationship. Listen, children, this question carries 8 marks in your annual exam. Okay. See, the same concept is there for 5th and 6th. So I have taken only one class for both of you. Okay. See, 5th class children and 6th class children are having the same concept. Okay, so you try to understand and do it. If you do those two problems, then you will come to know. Is it clear, children? Thank you. Have a nice day.